Two magic to help you sleep. I can't speak to the circadian rhythms of everyone who might listen to this, but for many of us, as the sun goes down and the air cools and the moon rises, bodies begin to signal to us that it would be useful to them to power down. Brains, however, soaked as they are in a week's worth of caffeine and bad ideas, writhe about and demand we busy ourselves with the imperfections of the day behind us. This does no one any clear good. So there are sleepy time teas, and milky lavender baths, and alcohol, and ASMR. And there is naturally a massive canon of magic created for just this purpose. You might light a candle, light it during the day when you can keep an eye on it, put a glass of water next to it as it burns. When you're ready for sleep, blow out the candle. Put the glass of water next to your bed to capture the noise and nightmares. When you wake up, pour the water out into the toilet, ideally, and begin your day with a fresh start. Take a selenite wand and write into your pillow your wishes for the new version of yourself that will wake in the morning. You can put crystals in your pillowcase. You can sing to the moon and ask her for aid. But mainly, the crackle, the buzzing, the noise of the universe out there spinning in its sonder, asking for you to give it bit more of your waking life, and much of that needs to be addressed, doing what you can during your waking life to make a clearly defined line between the work that is given to us to do between dusk and dawn and the work we must do in the astral realms. So this magic is a dream magic. Battles the beast by making the dream world infinitely more appealing. It happens by setting that intention. Or just turn off your electronics and endure the silence for a moment. And give a little smile to Queen Mab, midwife of dreams. Lay back down comfortably and consider. Slowly, as though you had 1,000 years to contemplate. Where would you like to go in the dark world this precious evening? What shall your name be? Whose advice would you like to seek, knowing they could be anywhere, or anyone who has ever been, or ever might? How would you like to feel? This adventure tell you a new story about who you are. It'd be a joy to return to the cobblestones of Rome, see on the piazza your one true love. Would it be a delight to eat ice cream as you swim with dolphins in an eternal purple sea? Your dream life has no judgment, and it will coil and turn to make itself useful to you, if you will give it the courtesy of telling it how to bend. If you've determined a plan for your dream life, listen. Listen for the crackle to be gone. If sleep has not stolen you yet, tell Queen Mab its details. Tell her to make a good one, darling. Entertain you both. And settle back, letting these pictures you've invented dance behind your eyelids. We'll know in a blink how you did. Be well. Sweet dreams.
name is Greg, and this is the General Eccentricity ASMR channel, and I have the pleasure of collaborating with a number of different ASMR artists today, and we each have about 5 minutes to do our thing, and I thought it might be fun to read a little bit of Shakespeare to you all, so I picked out my copy of Romeo and Juliet. And I was going to read just a few lines from the famous balcony scene. So, he just sits scars that never felt a wound. But soft, what light through yonder window breaks? It is the east, and Juliet is the sun. Arise, fair sun, and kill the envious moon, who is already sick and pale with grief, that thou, her maid, art far more fair than she. Be not her maid, since she is envious. Her vestal livery is but sick and green, and none but fools do wear it. Cast it off. It is my lady. Oh, it is my love. Oh, that she knew she were. She speaks, yet says nothing. What of that? Her eye discourses, I will answer it. I am too bold. 'Tis not to me she speaks. Two of the fairest stars in all the heaven, having some business, do entreat her eyes to twinkle in their spheres till they return. What if her eyes were there, they in her head? The brightness of her cheek would shame those stars, as daylight doth a lamp. Her eyes in heaven would through the airy region stream so bright that birds would sing and think it were not night. See how she leans her cheek upon her hand. Oh, that I were a glove upon that hand, that I might touch that cheek. She speaks. Oh, speak again, bright angel, for thou art as glorious to this night, being o'er my head, as is a winged messenger of heaven unto the white upturned wondering eyes of mortals that fall back to gaze on him. When he bestrides the lazy puffing clouds and sails upon the bosom of the air. Oh, Romeo, Romeo, wherefore art thou, Romeo? Deny thy father and refuse thy name, or if thou wilt not, be but sworn my love, and I'll no longer be a Capulet. 'Tis but thy name that is my enemy. Thou art thyself, though not a Montague. What's Montague? It is nor hand, nor foot, nor arm, nor face, nor any other part belonging to a man. Oh, be some other name. What's in a name? That which we call a rose by any other word would smell as sweet. So Romeo would, were he not Romeo called, retain that dear perfection which he owes without that title. Romeo, doff thy name, and for thy name, which is no part of thee, take all myself. Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. If you are new to the channel, it's nice to see you. Welcome, welcome. This is Gaming in ASMR. On my channel, I like to play some relaxing games and mix that with some ASMR. license plate.